singles or padded? Is that like a solid wood box?
Looking a lot better.
It's getting closer.
Yeah, I want you pausing the dip though. So here for 4 seconds, check the balance, make sure bar's not sliding down traps or anything, and then the jump.
You got 25 kilos or above, you start counting.
How many more?
I wouldn't even try to get to that point. As long as it feels like you're hitting simultaneously, that'd be fine.
And not worry about that, I'm worried about
it. Yep. Just
yep. Perfect. Back to your right, and then all of a sudden I'll turn on my front foot. I'm like, come on.
Yeah, and that's one of the reasons too, like when since here you teach, like, okay, this position is great, the how far out depends on the foot anatomy, right?
Yeah.
So I have toes that come more, much more like this, so my heel has to go out more to get it. With the front foot, though, as soon as I try to come back to this position, if I do anything other than try to take this heel out as well, and that's a way over exaggeration, but that's when it gets all fucked up. If I try to do this and a heavy jerk,
I know, I felt really good.
I'm like, let's just go right to a...
So everything from here to here was good, and then it went to shit. So, like I said, I spoke too soon, but the only other thing I would tell you is before you get started, make sure your knees are straight. So you're kind of in this strong, tense position, which the heavy weights isn't gonna cut. It's so we can get as relaxed as we can before.
Makes sense. Save your energy, right?
What?
Save your energy.
Yes. Personal experience, though, will tell me that you can't. Let's not drop that into those weights unless we have to.
Maybe I just need more weight.
Yep.
Yep.
Jeez, I feel consistent. Like. So much easier to just hold it there when your chin's down. It's weird. Well, my front foot turned out, and I was like, whoa. Well, we got to 95.